Hi everyone!
Hello!
This is our first video on our series on English for health professionals or for teachers teaching these professionals.
We are going to show you how to take a patient's history in English.
Taking a patient's history is a skill any medical professional should have.
You probably know how to do it in your native language, but do you know how to do it in English?
So here we're gonna show you the steps and simulate conversations for you to see how it happens in real life.
We're gonna divide the process into 8 steps.
Today we're gonna show you the first 4.
Step 1.
Introduce yourself.
Identify your patient.
And ask for consent to ask questions and take notes.
Hi, I'm Dr. Anna Smith. Can you tell me your complete name, please?
It's Christina Johnson.
Is it okay if I ask you some questions?
Sure.
Do you mind if I take some notes?
Not a problem.
Okay.
Step 2. Presenting complaints. PC.
This is the time when the patient tells you what is wrong with him or her. So, what seems to be the problem?
I have a pain, a bad stomachache.
Step 3. Socrates.
Site.
Onset.
Character.
Radiation.
Associations.
Time course.
Exacerbating or relieving factors.
Severity. Where exactly is the pain?
Here, in the upper abdomen.
When did it start?
3 days ago.
So you have been feeling this pain for 3 days, okay? Does it come and go?
Yeah, it comes and goes.
Does it come gradually or suddenly?
It comes suddenly.
And is the pain sharp?
No, it's more like a burning sensation.
Does it move anywhere? Do you feel it radiating?
No, it kind of stays here.
Do you have any other symptoms like nausea, vomiting, and heartburn?
Yeah, when the pain comes, I feel nauseated.
Nauseated. Okay, but no vomiting?
None so far.
No vomiting. When the pain comes, does it last too long?
Yeah, last night it lasted for about an hour.
So, do you think that each episode lasts the same?
I'm not sure.
Have you noticed anything that makes this pain worse? Like, for example, when you eat something or when you are hungry?
Yeah, it gets worse after I eat.
Any particular kind of food?
No, but it tends to be worse after dinner. But I usually have a snack for dinner.
Okay. On a scale of 1 to 10, how bad is this pain?
I give it an 8.
Step 4. Past medical history. PMH. Is it the first time you have been feeling this pain?
No, I had the same problem last year, but then it went away on its own.
How long did it last last year?
Just one day, and the next day I was fine.
Didn't you get any treatment for it?
No, not really.
Okay. Have you undergone any changes lately? For example, work, family, eating habits?
No. I'm on a diet now. I've been trying to eat more healthily.
Were you on this diet the last time you felt this pain?
No, I was eating a lot of junk food at the time.
Okay. So, this is our first video on how to take a medical history.
Stay tuned to watch the second part and to find out what's wrong with Christina Johnson.
So, if you like this video, please hit the like button.
Subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to follow us on Instagram.
Yeah.
Share this video with your friends.
Bye.
Bye.